Chapter 4. It's a mystery. When I got to the bus stop the next morning, I found Joey Pignatano staring into his hand. "What are you doing, Joey?" I asked.
"Training," he answered.
I looked closer. An ant crawled on Joey's palm. Joey closed his eyes, brought his hand to his mouth, and swallowed. The poor ant never knew what hit him. One minute he was crawling around, searching for a crumb. The next minute, the little guy was trapped inside Joey Pignatano's belly. What a way to go. Joey licked his lips and shrugged. "Not so bad," he said.
"Sure,"
I said. "Better than raisinettes. But a tiny ant is not exactly a squishy worm."
"I know," Joey said earnestly. "I'm working my way up the animal kingdom."
Yeesh. Mila skipped out of her house the minute she saw Joey. Mila started singing. "Nobody likes me, everybody hates me. Guess I'll go eat worms. First you peel the skin off, then you chew the guts up. Ooey gooey worms." When the bus pulled away, I watched as Mila's house got smaller and smaller until it was the size of a bug.
"Did you decide yet what you're gonna be for Halloween?"
Mila asked me. I shrugged.
"I don't know. A pirate, I guess. Or maybe a gorilla.
Or Frankenstein, I think." "How about you?" I asked. Mila smiled. "Here's a hint.
I want to suck your blood."
We both laughed. Mila was going to be a vampire. "My stepmom Alice is suing me this really cool black cape, and I already have a set of plastic fangs." Then I told her what my brothers had told me about the mummy and how he walks through town on Halloween and causes all sorts of trouble. Ralphie Jordan, who was sitting in front of us, turned around. "It's true," he said. "Barney Fodstuck even saw the mummy with his own eyes."
"How do you know?" I asked.
"Everybody knows about the mummy," Ralphie said. "It knocked down Earl Bartholomew last year. Earl Bartholomew was an 8th grader who lived across the street from Ralphie."
"Are you sure?"
Ralphie's eyes lit up, bright and large. "It was Halloween night. Earl was in a hurry, so he cut through Green Lawn Cemetery. Suddenly, he felt someone push him in the back. Earl fell and chipped a tooth. But when he turned around, no one was there."
"Maybe he tripped," I said.
Ralphie shook his head.
"No, Jigsaw. He was pushed."
"Well," Mila said, pulling out her long black hair, "it sounds like a mystery to me." I pulled out my detective journal. I turned to a new page. With an orange marker, I wrote, "The Case of the Mummy Mystery. This looks like a job for Jigsaw Jones, Private Eye."